The Defence Department has denied it's dragging its feet when it comes to contamination around the RAAF base at Richmond. Last night we brought you the story of the McLaren family, who have high levels of a toxic chemical in their system that they blame on firefighting foam from the base. Today we went looking for answers.
This is the face of a man who feels betrayed.
We've lost everything.
Alistair McLaren and his family feared they were being contaminated by the chemicals known as PFAS from the nearby Richmond RAAF base. Blood tests organised by Nine News proved they were, as were their cattle. The Defence Department knew about the dangers of PFAS in 2003, but only contacted Richmond locals in 2016. It denies it's dragged its feet.
Well, I would refute that comment very strongly. We're conducting scientifically credible investigations that are being conducted at a rate quicker than most other environmental investigations into contaminants.
But that doesn't include human blood tests. The McLarens blame other agencies for failing to put pressure on Defence. Dominic Perrottet is the local member. He says his office has been liaising with the Environment Department.
They've been door-knocking residents and they have been providing as much...
five.
My understanding is that the department has been speaking to residents.
As for talking to those concerned residents himself...
There was a community meeting that was held that my office attended and to work through those issues. And
so were you in that meeting or not?
No, there was a community meeting that was held...
No, were you in the meeting?
There was a community meeting that was held that my chief of staff at the office attended.
The EPA refused an interview, but in a statement said the Commonwealth Department of Defence is responsible, adding Defence is the polluter. The EPA has no jurisdiction, it said, but will be monitoring any investigations closely. But the EPA isn't alone. This is the tangle of state and federal agencies who have some responsibility for this. Ultimately, it means nothing because Defence is a law unto itself.
There are already three class actions due to begin here in the federal court in August for communities around Williamtown, Oakey and Catherine. But lawyers believe there could be up to 30 other communities that are contaminated, and Richmond is definitely on their radar for potential litigation.
The firm already funding those three class actions will now talk to Richmond locals.
The Commonwealth's response has been, I think, handicapped by the fact that it has one eye on its potential liability.
Federal member Susan Templeman says more now needs to be done in her community.
We need to see the results of testing, and the testing needs to be the sorts of things this community wants to see. Can they eat their eggs? Can they garden? What are the implications for people who live right near the base?
Eddie Meyer, Nine News.